So you've finished the Umbrella Academy Series 2, you've absorbed all the twists, got your head around all those alternate timelines, and endlessly replayed that bit where Allison forces Diego to smack himself in the noggin.
I heard a rumor. You punched yourself in the face.
And now you're hungry for more kooky, super-powered sci-fi, right? More ragtag underdogs teaming up and sticking it to the man. I'm going to assume that you've already seen this understated little show called Stranger Things, by the way. Just a wee Netflix original, keeping itself to itself there. And recommend a load of awesome content you may not be so familiar with. So here are five things to watch now that you've finished The Umbrella Academy Series 2.
What the hell did we do now?
The Old Guard is a Netflix original movie starring Charlize Theron as Andy, the leader of a clandestine group of super fighters with a very unique ability indeed.
Let's just say, we're very hard to kill.
They're all physically immortal. Shoot them down, and they're all just gonna get right back up again. This covert team of never-dead mercenaries has protected the Earth for centuries, but now they face a new threat.
If we can unlock their genetic code, the entire world will be begging us for the key.
Corporate greed. A shady group of villains want to monetize the Old Guard's remarkable abilities, so it's a good job they've got new recruit Niall, played by Kiki Lane, to freshen things up a bit and provide a much-needed numbers boost for our kick-ass warrior army.
You're an army of four?
I think you mean an army of four immortals, Niall. Although, to be fair, the constant running, fighting, shooting, and evading surprise explosions does all seem quite stressful. It's a great movie, though. And if the Umbrella Academy has given you a taste for titanic groups of super-powered heroes taking on the world together, The Old Guard is definitely one you should check out. Our next entry is a bit of a mouthful, so bear with me. Dirk Gently's Holistic Detective Agency is a wacky sci-fi series based on the novel of the same name by Douglas Adams, with the author self-describing his book as a thumping good detective ghost horror whodunit time travel romantic musical comedy epic. Which sounds about as bonkers as you'd expect from a guy who wrote The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. And it is. Samuel Barnett plays the titular Dirk, an eccentric former CIA agent turned holistic detective who solves crimes by observing the interconnectedness of things. Yeah, I don't really get it either. Like, can you actually solve crimes this way?
Sure, tons. Well, some.
Yeah, I'm not convinced, and neither is poor Todd Brotman, played by Elijah Wood, a hapless bellboy whose day starts out badly.
Also, you're fired.
And only gets worse as he returns home to find Dirk halfway through his window.
Hi.
From here, it's a chaotic scramble to escape the clutches of the mysterious Blackwing, a secret project focused on researching people with strange abilities in a unique and hilarious show that's best summed up by the man himself.
Everything is connected. Nothing is also connected.
So if watching The Umbrella Academy has made you hungry for time travel, eccentric characters stumbling through chaos, or just a sci-fi story with its tongue firmly in its cheek, you have to watch Dirk Gently's Holistic Detective Agency. I promise you, it's a cracker. We've got another Netflix original coming up next in the shape of Project Power, an exhilarating action thriller starring Jamie Foxx and Joseph Gordon-Levitt sets in a world where a new type of super pill grants users 5 minutes of pure power. Or pure power, if you've got to know with an Irish accent. Looks like one heck of a trip, especially when you factor in these pills are totally random. So whenever you pop one, you're essentially playing superpower lucky dip, with results as varied and spectacular as invisibility, being on fire, or the ability to bounce bullets off your face. Basically, if you enjoyed the unconventional yet visually spectacular superpowers of the Umbrella Academy, watching Project Power is going to feel like being in a massive sci-fi sweet shop. As is always the case, there's a criminal organization looking to profit from all this chaos, which means Jamie and Joseph need to team up and take them down. Sort of like Batman and Robin, I guess.
No, Batman and Robin, that's a movie, this is real life.
Nah, this is a movie too, albeit one with brutal action set pieces, a stellar cast at the top of their game, and one thirsty waitress.
You need anything else?
No, I'm fine.
Yes, you are.
Project Power is waiting for you on Netflix right now. We've got something a bit different up next, but what Tales of the City lacks in superpowers and big chunks of moon rock falling to Earth, it more than makes up for in terms of warmth, diversity, and having Ellen Page in it. Tales of the City follows the story of Marianne Singleton, played by Laura Linney, who returns to 28 Barbary Lane, San Francisco, after a 23-year absence. This is a special place, not just because it's the home of 90-year-old Anna Madrigal, but also thanks to the people who've passed through it and the stories they've left behind.
There is no better reward in a person's life than to see a building turn from walls of brick to a nest of warm stories.
Ellen Page plays Shauna Hawkins, a young woman navigating both a new relationship and also a generational culture clash.
What's up, millennial?
Do not ever call me that again.
This often humorous, sometimes dramatic collision of characters, backgrounds and ideas is what Tales of the City is all about. The cast is a vibrant kaleidoscope of different ages, sexual orientations and gender identities. The story is unique and challenging, and you can check out all 10 episodes on Netflix right now. Finally, if you finished the Umbrella Academy and just want to kick back with a gang of super-powered girls kicking all of the arse, then Warrior Nun is an absolute must-watch. Ava is your typical teenage girl, until that is she wakes up in a morgue with inexplicable new abilities. Abilities such as the power to phase through objects, and also just being really, really good at fighting. So good that she can hit a man so hard that he bursts. Joining Ava in the Order of the Cruciform Sword, basically an historic team of warrior nuns, are Beatrice with her epic martial arts prowess, Shotgun Mary with her shotgun, Lilith, who's handy with a blade, and Camilla, who spreads the word of the Lord not through Bibles, but through ballistics. Ava is still very much the star, however, the magical halo burned into her body, effectively positioning her as the chosen one who will lead the warrior nuns into battle against the very worst of both heaven and hell. With unique characters, wry humor, and fight choreography every bit as sharp as its one-liners, Warrior Nun is the perfect pick-me-up for those post-Umbrella Academy blues. Check it out on Netflix today. Let us know if you have any recommendations in the comments, give this video a like if you find it helpful, and click that notification bell so you're always up to speed with everything on Netflix.